The government is going to consult on the proposal to increase the speed limit in England and Wales from 70 to 80 miles an hour. I'm a PhD student here at the Centre for Transport Studies at University College London, and I have a particular interest in citizen participation, which is why I initiated a citizen's jury on the subject of motorway speed limits. Now, the idea of a citizen's jury is to gather a demographically representative sample of the British people and present them with expert evidence on a topic of social importance. We've come across five arguments that have been used to date by the government in the information that has been published so far about the idea of increasing the speed limit. The first relates to the greatly increased safety of vehicles since the limit was imposed in 1965 and the considerable reduction in deaths on British roads over the same period. The second is an argument in favour of considerable economic benefits arising from an increased speed limit. A third talks about compatibility, that the UK would resemble more some of its European counterparts if it had that speed limit. And a fourth talks about finding the best balance between costs and benefits, and 80 miles per hour being presented as that. The fifth argument is that millions of motorists who are currently exceeding the speed limit would be brought back within the law.
There are many risks associated with increasing speed. There's safety, there's increase in pollution, increase in petrol usage, and interestingly enough, because of reduced travel times, we believe that people will choose to travel further, and that in itself will increase the exposure to risk and the number of accidents. So far as safety is concerned, increasing speed almost always leads to increase in casualties. And in any crash that happens, the higher the speed, the greater the risk of injury. There is almost certainly no congestion benefit of increasing the speed limit. When the traffic's heavy, it's the presence of other vehicles that limits drivers' speeds. So drivers might wish to go faster, but they can't because there's other traffic in front. Changing the speed limit will allow some drivers to drive faster when the traffic's light.
We've got to put money into enforcing things so that they run properly. I just don't see the point in changing it.
Against raising it.
So I wouldn't drive any faster than I already do. So my behaviour as a driver is not going to change.
People's opinions became more sceptical concerning the arguments that had been put forward supporting an increase to 80. Two of the three groups arrived at the conclusion that the speed limit should stay at 70. One suggested 80, but insisted that it should be enforced at 80. Having done it, we talked with officers at the Department for Transport who are working on this project in readiness for the beginning of the consultation. And they were very glad to hear what we had to say. They found what we told them very interesting and asked lots of questions. So hopefully the citizens' jury hasn't simply been an interesting exercise for our own benefit, but has also, to some extent, informed the thinking of the Department for Transport itself.